Another important concept is the effect of linear expansion on bimetallic strip. Say, if two metal strips are joined together by some rivets like this, say on one side we keep aluminium and the other side we keep copper, and these are riveted like this. And using these rivets, these are always combined to each other. These are not allowed to be detached. And say we know alpha of aluminium is more than alpha of copper. And in the initial situation, the length of this combined rod is L0. Now, if we increase the temperature of the system, obviously as alpha for aluminium is more, the aluminium will expand more. Copper will expand less, but they are not allowed to move away from each other due to rivets. The final structure after increase in temperature would look like this. This would be the aluminium and this would be the copper. The rod will bend in concave form towards the side of copper. Because aluminium expanded more, so this would become L1. Because the other edge of this rod was not attached to any other position, the other length of copper rod will become L2. And here L1 we can write L0 1 plus alpha aluminium delta T. And L2 we can write L0 1 plus alpha copper delta T. So, these are the lengths we use, and we can say due to the bend in the copper tube, it will have some radius of curvature and the angle subtended by the bimetallic strip at the center of this bimetallic strip, which is bent in form of a circular arc. If its radius is R, we can easily calculate by using the geometry. Like if we wish to find out the angle theta, it can be written as L1 by R plus the thickness T1. If initial thickness of both are same, the final can be taken as T1 or T2. This can be written as L2 upon R minus T2. On substituting these values here and on solving the results, we can get the radius of curvature as well as the angle subtended by the arc at the center of this circular arc. Using this also, many various kind of applications can be handled.